through studying invasive species, one thing you become very aware of is the delicate balance that we have in our ecosystems. When you have the introduction of a very invasive plant like Phragmites, what it operates as is just a huge disturbance event that completely throws that ecosystem out of whack. Introduced Phragmites has been in Canada for many, many years, and it's only in kind of relatively recent times that it's developed into this huge invasive problem. Now we have Phragmites taking over huge expanses of land and completely destroying the biodiversity of those areas.
What makes Phragmites really dangerous for wetlands is it grows very quickly and it drives out all other species, that you only get one or two, maybe three different species living in a stand of Phragmites. It's really hard for turtles to move through there. It's even marsh birds, which are supposed to be able to move through tight spaces, they struggle in here. They just don't get the habitat they need, they don't get the food they need.
What we're trying to do is reestablish some sort of ecological balance between, in this case, an invasive plant and its natural enemies. With biological control, what we're doing is going back to the native range, in this case Europe, and we're screening a variety of different things that normally eat Phragmites to try and find one that only eats Phragmites. We're working with two biocontrol agents, they're moths, but the damaging stage of the biocontrol agent itself is a caterpillar that feeds within the stem of the Phragmites.
The rearing of these moths takes place both in Switzerland at CABI, who are one of our major collaborators, and here at the University of Toronto. And much of the funding for that rearing comes from Ducks Unlimited Canada. And so that's what's enabling us to rear these moths on this scale. So what we're doing in this room is setting up cages for the adult moths. The adult moths will then be placed in cages with 10 to 20 Phragmites stems. And what the adults actually do is they lay their eggs under the leaf sheaths of these Phragmites stems. So what us and the rest of our staff here at the lab will do is slowly dissect those stems to harvest the eggs, which will then form the group of insects or the cohort of insects that we'll release next spring in various new Phragmites infestations.
There's two different ways that we release the biocontrol agents. One way is as larvae that are contained within these cut Phragmites stems. Right here, there's the entry hole where the larvae has bored into the Phragmites stem. There's a larvae inside here now. And the larvae will feed in here for a bit, and then they'll bore their way out and move into another of the Phragmites stems around me. So what we're looking at here are two egg release cups for the two moths that we're working with. The larvae drop out of the bottom into the Phragmites stem. We had to put them in these cups to protect the eggs from predators who would eat them before they hatched.
The biocontrol agents are not going to come in and eradicate Phragmites. What they're going to do is they're going to, through their life cycle, they're going to weaken Phragmites and suppress it, which will allow native vegetation the chance to come back in and sort of reestablish in that invaded territory.
A common question and a reasonable question with biological control is how safe is it? What we do is a series of host range experiments to see whether these insects will, under any circumstances, feed on anything else.
The work to do the screening to make sure that it only eats Phragmites for the two moths that we're talking about started in 1998, was finished in 2018. And the reason it takes quite a while to do that testing is because you have to test it against a whole bunch of representative species to make sure these insects only eat Phragmites, will only develop on Phragmites. And that's, we're confident that it will be safe in terms of releasing it into the environment.
Ducks Unlimited Canada have been a perfect collaborator for us in this project because they're so well known for working in wetlands and they have vast swathes of land that they manage. And so they've been a great source of information for us in terms of finding infestations of Phragmites where we can release these insects and where we have access to regularly monitoring them.
Big problems, you need a lot of work to tackle them. It couldn't be done if we didn't have all these great partners working together.
The partnerships for this project are critical. A lot of people have come together to help solve a common problem, which none of us can solve on our own.